factory. So we've got the production science, well, the purple science and the yellow science are all done, and they're running. And I am leaving my benchmarking suite going while I do this. You can see we're maintaining 900, and it's time to build blue. So let's add blue to our list. We're going to need 26 machines making blue science with the beginning and so on. And let's do the rest of this on site as well. Okay, advanced circuits can come in and can be imported. We do need to make engine units on site. I don't think there's any reason to have a separate factory for engine units. And of course, you do the pipes and the gears there. We need to put these in the sub-factory. Here we go. So I think this is the build that we're going to do inside this little area. So 16 to 26, this isn't going to be something we're going to do a one-to-one or a pass-through or anything. It's almost 2 to 3? Yeah. Okay, let's just make the 16 and belt it. How many belts are we talking about here? Nothing's over half a belt, so everything here can fit on half a belt. We're good. Let's start off with the 26. If I was going to, I could overbuild that a little bit. Let's see. If I build three rows of 10, that's a slight overbuild. Judge the rest of it based on information from information from the max rate calculator. So guys have three inputs and an output, which is just begging for a split belt of two of the inputs and then the third input to share with the output belt, which we have done so many times elsewhere. Let's just go review one of those designs real quick. This isn't typical because, you know, we've got one thing that's high volume. So here's our typical layout, and in fact, we can just copy-paste this. Oh, I've got a bunch of fuel there. And I will just extend the length and change the recipes a little bit, and we'll be ready. Or I could put it vertically, just like that. Yeah. Distance from there. There we go. go 8x4. Six 6x4 would get me 12, 24, and 8, 27. 3x8 would be 24 as well. Or, well, we could keep them too. Let's do this. You are blue. So let's do that again. I will trim from the top to get the right number and then do adjustments. Halfway up. You know what? If I do 7 and 7 and make 4 of them across. Yeah, okay. So 1, 2. So if I do that, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So I would be ticking up here to the top. Inside, that'll merge. all of this together in a box. Just like that. We're going to go a little extra margin there, so now we need engines. This looks like it's going to be 4 engine machines on each row. And we'll just... how do we make the engines get their inputs when we already have... Well, 2 of these inputs are going to be locked up. This is output and input, so we're going to have to put the engines over here. Something needs to be on the inside of this for blue. Well, maybe that's engines. But that does mean that on the right-hand side we would have that. Yeah, I don't think we can put engines in here as it stands. We will have to bring our other inputs in. Well, we can do that. We can do that. If our engines are on... Oh, these are asymmetric, that's right. Plop. If our engines are on the inside lane here... We could put them like that, so now we can get engines off of this guy. Now we can have engines on either lane, and we can have something else on the other lane, and we'll be fine. Now this guy. This guy's going to need to have the other 2 inputs, which means this needs to be sulfur and red circuits. That needs to be fed in somehow. personal a little bit of distance here. Gets us our silver and advanced circuit inputs from over here. Let me mark that so I don't forget. Those will have to come from a train. And above this, we need engines outputting to that line there. And we can use that as an input, so engines have a three-way. That'll be fine. Let's go pick up some more stuff. This was not enough beacons. Okay, and how did we do for other things? Modules? We could probably use a few more of the productivity modules. 150, that's enough. Phil. Now back to it. Thank you. normal. We're gonna bring some in and take some out. Let's see, where's our power? If we keep to our current paradigm, would be here. Like that. Something on the inside. We don't particularly care what is there yet. And the other belt has two things on it. Steel and gears and pipes. These are doable in one machine, and we'll see here. Notice the volumes of inputs and outputs. Let's look at this in terms of items per second per machine. You just have huge volumes coming in where they're beaconed and moduled like this. So it's going to be mini loaders and splitters. Or I can do mini loaders and I could just put them in here. Iron into mini loader worth of iron going into each one. That's not gonna happen in this layout. Okay, never mind. Okay, without beacons, this gets pretty horrible. let's put the speed back in. Yeah, because I can bring the steel in. So part of the challenge is I'm trying to sneak the steel past these guys. Oh. No, because he's already got three inputs and an output. I can't sneak the steel past him. So, yeah. That's not going to work in any way. So, So between this guy and this guy, we need to route our engines to the right place and then bring in all of our inputs. Why am I thinking about steel coming down here? You doofus. Steel is needed by these guys, not by those guys. So, yeah. Let's look at this. We have... gears. And... we have pipes. And steel. I'm inclined to keep the power on the outside, just because that keeps it symmetric between the two. Like that. There's also a thing, if I'm going to be swizzling inputs, keeping every lane the same would be good as well. So let's go ahead and just kill off the way I was doing this. Let's make it four identical lanes. So, whatever we plan out here, we will do identically. So, for the engines, we are going to need something like this, bringing the engines to the right, and doing that. For this side, we have our two inputs here, which we are terminating. Something from the left that we will split to here. How far can we jump over? That works. So we'll just be feeding our inputs on the right, just like that. Now, with everything populated, this should balance out to a quarter of what we need. So this says, well, 1/4 of 900 would be 225. So we are well over it, and we have almost enough engines for that much overkill. We're short by one engine. But we're doing 150 engines total. If we look at this, our total engines that we need are, what is per minute? 714. So 150 by 4 is 600. So we are short engines. Well, that's not right. Oh, I forgot to put prod modules in. There. Let's try this again. So now we're doing 184, and we are only 3/100 of a machine low, which means that we will still be able to do more than we need. We only needed 125. Yeah. For this, 714. So 714 divided by 4 is going to be less than 200. We are, yeah, okay, I have to do math. 184.8. 184.8 times 4 equals. Clear. So we're going to do 739. We needed 714. So this is close enough. We're just barely over. We won't have much margin, but our margin is based on the fact that we're going to be headed up towards the 1,000 level. So now we need to have on here, we need some combination of something on the inside here and something on both sides there, where it's steel and two kinds of pipes. And I think we can sacrifice a little bit here by saying this guy is going to take steel. We're going to take something to the right. How about we put pipes on the left-hand side and gears on the right? No, we already figured out we couldn't bring in stuff fast enough if we do that. Okay. So 900 per minute. I want to buffer 2 minutes worth there in that box. Did I buffer anything anywhere else? I'm thinking maybe I didn't buffer in the other ones. No, I didn't. Let's not even buffer. In fact, and I'm going to do a lane balancer. So both of these are going to be on the right. Balancing evenly across all four, but we are saying these two will be drawn evenly, these two will be drawn evenly, and the two pairs will be drawn evenly. That may come out to the same thing. I think it does. Okay, and the top. So now we need to get our machine, it'd be 17 input per second, but we're only going to do a quarter of that, so that's a little bit over 4 per second. So if a stack inserter could do that. So now we just need a place for the iron to come in that will not be left on this lane. So we can do that by having that machine there. And what are we going to keep? We're going to keep pipes on the left. Out. How does that make it so that we can get iron, you know, into this guy? It doesn't. We can't get iron into this guy. Okay, we're left with the same thing again.
Thank you.
Okay, cat break over. So I was looking at how I would bring in the steel. I think this basic plan is good. So we do this from here, and then we try to jump all the way over to there. There we go. And so that gets our steel. Make it clear that this does tile. So there's our steel input. So now we need our iron input, which if I do the iron through like this, because that's really the same as just doing this. So what if I go ahead and check this out? Okay. So until I get all the modules in, these aren't going to be correct. So let's go back and get another set of modules. If I had that much space, let's, as long as I've got that much space, let's use it. This does not allow for this guy. Okay, so we can use productivity modules in the gears, but not in the pipes. Fine. Okay, so this is now built. So now if we check with max rate calculator, we see that we have enough red machines for 104.3. We have not enough engines to keep all of those busy, but more than enough we need for the 1,000 science. And we have way overkill on our gears and pipes, because that's how we're getting this to be a tileable thing. However, since this is 2.2 excess machines, we could really just use two of these and split it out. But I don't see any benefit from the extra complexity. And this still gives us all of our inputs on the left. So, if we look at this, this means that our ingredients, we have got gear wheels and pipes down here, so our grades are going to be iron and steel and sulfur and advanced circuits. If you look at what we pulled out to the left, we do see those four things. The quantities we need in terms of wagons per minute, these are all very low, so we could do all of these with a single... Well, iron is 0.3 wagons per minute. I'm tempted to bring in a 4 train for iron and then do the others as ones. Let's see, items per minute. Go up. So there's our total items per minute and our total wagons per minute. Iron plate we're going to do as a 4 train, and we'll do the others as 1 trains. So, first, iron. This is... Let's get the train station correct. Iron for blue science. All the way up. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to about here where they grid up? Close enough. Station. This is going to go get fuel. It doesn't actually sort it by station name very well. Wait for full cargo and inactivity. And then we have be able to just shift click on the station. Is there any way to copy that? Oh, I can type in fuel. That works. Okay, that helps. And empty cargo and inactivity. So now we give it some fuel. And we tell it to go get some. So our other cargoes here are steel, advanced circuits, and sulfur. I wish I could just type coal and steel like that. Thank you. and red circuits, and okay. These are ones. We do have steel, and there is one stop accessible. Full cargo and inactivity, and then back to steel for blue circuits. Empty cargo and inactivity. Yeah, I'm glad we have that search for the station name. These are getting kind of crazy. We do need to make sure we duplicate these. Trains alone. And give it one fuel. So you go get some, and then you drop off and go get some. This is advanced circuits. Path for now, instead of saying destination full often. And here's sulfur. There is no sulfur station. So all these guys now have two trains, and the sulfur is the only station we need to add on the left. Let's go add it. Once we get the station set up, I will start setting the unloading stations. Not like getting hit by a train. So next one up is here. So I grab sulfur. We need some more of these guys. This guy is just So it's very likely at some point that our throughput is going to be limited due to the fact that I am only filling up at the rate of one blue belt per cargo wagon. Red ships have large stacks, so it's going to take even longer to fill up that train. Three of our inputs. Last input is iron. We really only need one belt of iron coming out. So we just need to hook that up. It goes way over here, where we need steel and then iron and then the other two. Let's go ahead and bundle these up. Tested this with infinite sources here, but we all know it's gonna work, right? Pump up the speed to maximum. I should not have done that. I should not have done that. Because I'm peeling off the wrong stuff. I have steel coming down, not engines, because I didn't block the... saying about, oh, I don't need to test this. So we're going to take steel off one direction, like that. And I just need to drain this until there's no more steel. That's not right, because these guys may not be consuming all of the possible inputs here. Inspection here. send one away. Like that. Okay, and now we can shift to using the constructed blue science. So now we need to find out why our chemical science packs are at half strength. These guys are stalled. It's only drawing from one side. Such an interesting, it should have been drawing at 900 from one side, but we had no way of drawing from half of our factory on that one side because we weren't merging them here. So this should eventually do the right thing. So the science labs are still only drawing from the bottom half of this because we are still using less than half a blue belt. But at least now we are allowing all four of our lanes to build. However, notice that we have run this guy out of input because these guys aren't getting engines. Because we weren't getting iron because we weren't buffering any iron up here. So I'd forgotten about that. We need to have inline buffers and then just put them in line here. So now the question is, how much do we want to buffer? Minutes per minute. I want to buffer, say, 2 minutes worth. Let's see. We need at least 700 sulfur buffered. We need to figure out how much per stack it is. Let's start off by buffering one stack. So we said 700. That's going to be 500. Let's buffer that much sulfur. Red chips, we need 1017. Let's buffer 2,000 of those. That is 10 stacks. Steel, we're going to buffer, say, 1,200, 1,100. Let's do 1,000. This is all very approximate. And iron plate. 4,000 iron plate. Let's just buffer the whole thing. Now, double check that I can fit all of these in one blue belt. Yes, I can. So, iron. I was going to say iron is the closest, but he's got four cargo. So that's only 1.5, so really advanced circuits are the closest. Yeah, I think we've got more than enough time for him to cycle around to get more, especially since we have two trains, so we're good. That should even us out now. As these guys are dipping down, and they should come back up as our blue science catches up. Let's make absolutely sure that the purple science is actually not broken. See, he also requires red, and it looks like red is just not buffering. So I may need to get two wagons of red in here somehow. Because, yeah, purple science, wagons per minute. So he requires a wagon every 0.3 wagons per minute. So, yeah. And he fills 8/10 of a belt. So we're skating on thin margin here. And notice he's got both of his trains out. Let's open up a second station for red sources. On most of my trains here. I won't be able to. Well, that one or more. means I also need to do it over on the left. Fix them all.